Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we just talked about what is React Formic, how to use it, why it is beneficial for us to write the React forms in Formic library, either you are writing React or React Native code. Okay, in this video we will try to identify the basic difference in writing React forms with Formic and without Formic. Without Formic means we will be just using simple HTML form and we will be just using state to update the state whenever the data is getting changed in the form to capture it. Okay. So this is the very basic example. I didn't wrote it. It's just a simple example. What we are having is, let's first take a look onto this one. So here this is a class-based component. Here we have just a single input text field and on whenever you are updating this text field, we are just updating the value. We are just using this dot set state data and we are getting the value from event.target. You can increase the number of fields. What you just need is you just need to update this state mechanism. Currently we have this data. In this data what we can have is currently we are capturing the name. So similarly here you can just provide name is equal to username and here we are capturing password, right? So in basic HTML form how we are capturing it, we are just writing plain HTML form and we are writing the DOM events. On change event we have written, so based on this on change event we are updating the state. Okay, and this update state is common. We can just actually write this as an arrow function, so we don't need to bind it to this object. This is just my preference. You can write it either binding with this object, this dot update state, and this is a common method we are writing. So what we have to do here, this dot set state. So we are actually assigning the new state to data. Here we have two properties, username and password. This is our state object we have. Okay, this dot state which has a data property. Even we can just simply have this directly. It has two properties. Okay, now what we can do is we are actually updating the state. So we can say this dot state current, this is the current state and whatever you are updating. So we can just get the name value pair from the event object. Const name value we are getting from the e.target. So this is called destructuring. From the event object e.target.value and name we are assigning. So these values will get updated here, right? So this is the very basic form, but what if I wanted to handle the validation also? Validation means here I wanted to first capture that if name is email is not correct provided correctly or username is not provided correctly, then how are we going to show the message? We are going to have another state, right? So here I will be going to have one message property and in that message property I will be updating that message property whenever there is any update is happening. Okay, so you can see the trouble now. You will keep updating this message property based on any validation criteria and whenever this message property is getting updated, the re-rendering will happen for the whole form because you are updating a state property. Similarly, this is the basic form. Now, in future you wanted to handle the different cases, validation cases, like if user haven't entered or touched that particular prop field, then you should not show any error message. So like user has touched this particular field or not, all these particular state we have to maintain. So if we are going to put everything here, like consider that visited property can be another property where you will be having, okay, username and password again and just checking if username and password has been visited by user or not, right? So it is like you will keep building this state object and for every small thing, when you do on blur event and on key up event, you will be updating this visited property for username and password. So whenever you are doing it, you are actually re-rendering the whole form component. Re-rendering will happen. So is this an ideal scenario? No, right? Consider this is a two fields, but what if you have a 10 to 20 form fields and there you are actually validating the form fields like this. Then it becomes very complex and not good enough for React, because React will be re-rendering every times whenever the state property is getting changed, right? So this is the traditional way of writing the forms. This is the class-based component. You can have a hooks also, the functional component. Hooks will also do the kind of same. Here you will be managing the state using hooks instead of writing this dot set state or this dot state. Here we will be using the use state hook, managing the properties here. Like you can have a name, here we can have a password, or you can have a single state object. Here you can have a set password, and similarly for the input text field, we have this. Here I can have input type password, value is password, and on the on change I will be calling set password. Right? The only difference is now if I keep increasing these, on change of either username and password, I end up re-rendering the whole component, right? Because whenever the state is getting updated, this is a functional component, but this JSX will render again to apply the state change which has happened, right? And consider that now we also need to handle the validation scenarios, different kind of custom validations, number of fields are getting increased. Then this particular case will also fail to optimize your component, right? What is the other option now? Other option is, let's talk about Formic. Formic gives you the best way to handle the form submission, best way to capture the values out of the form, best way to handle the change events. Like here we are doing on change events. So there can be input text fields, radio, checkbox, radio group, select, all these different form components can be there. So Formic library is providing the pre-built set of components, and Formic is using renderer props to do all these things. They are not re-rendering the form whenever a particular state is getting updated in the Formic component. Okay, let's see this. So here I have created basic Formic component. Okay, what I'm doing here is, first of all, how to introduce Formic. You have to install npm install --save formic, that's it. Now here I'm using few things from the Formic, which is a form field Formic. Okay, there are many ways to do it. It's not like always you have to, you can just use only Formic as a component. You can also use Formic as a hook, use state hook. You can use Formic as a higher order component. You can wrap your component around the Formic, with Formic, use Formic, or the Formic component. So there are many possible ways to introduce Formic in your component. We'll talk about this step by step, how to actually use Formic in your component, either by hooks, either by component, or either by higher order component, or either by using context. Okay, so this is the Formic we have, and we are using Formic component here. Okay, so what we have done is we have provided the initial values for the form. Now it can have a name, email, password, first name, last name. If you wanted to initialize them, put it here. And I also have created one validate function. So what that validate function is doing, that validate function is validating if name is not there in the errors, it is just putting the requirement, I mean error.name, and we are returning that object here. Okay, and on submit we are getting the values out of it, and in the actions, like these actions are pre-built actions. Here we can just do set submitting false and reset form. Reset form will empty all the values once form is submitted after this timeout, and set submitting false means form has been submitted after 1 second. Okay, here we are using render. So this is the basic form, and this form component is rendering something, and this is the form which Formic itself is providing. This is not HTML form. First of all, here we got the fields props.touch.name, props.error.name. So here we don't need to deal with, okay, which particular field has been touched, which particular field has an error. So it is saying that you have touched this field and this field has an error. So let's show that error message from this props.error.name, which we have set here. Okay, and this error message will come. So if you are just typing something, error message is gone. If you are not typing, then error message appears. So all these things, if you try to do with simple React component without forming, then you will be updating the state object to achieve this. Right? Here I'm not doing that. Here I'm just doing it with the React format. Okay? So this is one way of doing it. We can also use hooks to achieve this. This is a very basic. Formic also provides you a way to write basic HTML form here. You don't need to go and use the Formic form component. Okay, from the next video, we will start talking about how to use Formic for your Hello World form, where you are just capturing username, password. This is just an example I wanted to talk about. What has changed now when you introduce Formic? You can have a validation function where you can do custom validation. Okay, I have like different values. There is an email, there is a password, right? So I will be just checking both the fields, email.password. I will just say password required. And this property is set on password. Okay. Similarly, here I have a name and password two fields. Initially, I initialize that with empty. Validate function has both the values. Here, this is the first field I have. So we can have another field which is password. Okay, just format it a little bit. Input type password, name is password here, not the name, and placeholder is just for information. Touched.name, similarly touch.password, errors.password. Okay, now if I just submit this, we are getting no password required because we are running validation, right? Now let me reload this form. And if I type something here, okay, password is required. Okay, so I test it. Now if I try to wait a second. So here we are actually initializing username, password, password required. We are returning error validation. Here we are checking password. Okay. So name is required. Similarly, we should get password required. Yeah, I think it was not loaded. I reloaded that time. Now everything is fine, right? So you can keep adding the form fields. It can be again wrapped inside another separate component, error message component. So your form will be concise. I mean, in the just a less number of lines, you are able to write forms because most of the responsibilities you have given to the forming. It is initializing the forming form values. If you want, like if you are getting something from the props that you wanted to initialize, you can do that. Validate method, you can do custom validation. Here in future, we will do the custom validation using yup. We will be writing a schema. Okay, these are the 10 form fields. We can do a validation, custom validation. Okay, username minimum character 5, password should be uppercase, lowercase, special character, all these kind of validation. And on submit method is a default one. So here in this code, do you see anywhere I'm writing on change event, submit event? No, right? Because this is a formic custom form. It is wrapping around the basic HTML form we have, right? This is the higher order component to that. We are not writing handle change. We are not writing on submit method here. Everything is being taken care by this. And on the name of on submit here, we are taking care of that. Okay. So we will talk about more examples and we will try to understand more about it and different ways of using Formic in your component. Thanks everyone.